This is the National Video Journalist Network.
When visiting North Wales, you must tour their many magical castles, take in the beautiful landscape, and when it's time to eat the locals' favorite dish, fish and chips, go to Tremeirchion. And at the Salusbury Arms, one of the oldest pubs in North Wales, co-owner Martin Boardman will blow you away with his great-grandmother's delicious recipe.
On a Friday evening, we do traditional fish and chips. We get the fish in fresh every day from Fleetwood. We use 2 kilos of flour, which is English wheat flour. To that, there's 2.6 litres of soda water and maybe 2 little secret ingredients. So that's the difference.
Which you're not going to tell me anything?
Oh, about? God, no. You'd have to pay me a lot of money. All the flour goes in. Okay, this is the worst bit because it's all handwork, but it's the best way to do it. Yeah, this is soda water. It gives it a bit more air and agitation in the mix. As you can see, the soda water's activating and the batter doesn't want to be too thick. The batter creates an envelope. You're sealing the outside, so the vapor's trying to get out. So if the batter's very thick, what you finish up with is a soggy layer around your fish, and that's when you try and peel away. Oh, I can't eat that. It's better to have a nice thin batter. This'll do us about 50 fish fillets. That's the dropping consistency of it. What we do then is we leave this now for 15-20 minutes, and the gluten in the flour will absorb the moisture, and you'll get a bit more thickness, so you have to then let it down a little bit.
While the batter sits, let's look at the fish.
We have cod or we have haddock. If the haddock is a better catch, we'll have the haddock. We trust our fishmonger for that. This is our fish that was delivered today. They're all topped and tailed, no bones.
The chips are actually thick-cut French fries. What Americans call chips, the British call crisps. Martin uses Maris Piper potatoes, which are cut, steamed, and set to dry in the fridge.
The beauty of the Maris Piper is that they dry fluffy. So when you fry them, they crisp up really great.
The fish and chips are served with a side of mushy peas. Martin purchases the peas dry.
Those have been soaking for just over a day and a half. Little bit of sugar, little bit of butter, touch of salt.
It's time to finish the batter. It's heavier, so Martin adds a little soda water.
That's perfect now. What we're going to do now is we're going to get some ice organized and set up a nice bath to stand it in. You work with this for 4-5 hours. As long as you keep it chilled, you're okay.
And finally, it's time to fry. The fish fillet are coated in flour, then dipped in batter, letting the excess drip off. The fish is carefully placed in the hot oil, and after a few seconds, it rises to the top. Drain before serving. Look at that golden flaky crust. Takeout orders are wrapped in paper, but the dine-in orders get a scoop of mushy peas, a full fillet of fish, and of course, chips.
And that is how fish and chips are made at the Salusbury Arms in North Wales.
And what's the verdict from the dining room? Yeah, thumbs up. Wouldn't expect anything else.